So we've just had the keynote for WWDC 2022, and at this event we saw the brand new macOS Ventura, and it gives us new features like Stage Manager and also the ability to use our iPhone as a webcam. However, would you like the ability to install Ventura onto your MacBook right now? Well, today I'm going to show you how to do this in this guide and how to install macOS Ventura onto your Mac or your MacBook, like this MacBook Air that I've got right here, without even having a developer's account. So without further ado, let's begin. Now, the first thing to mention is a disclaimer, and that is that it's up to you if you want to install macOS Ventura. I'm not forcing you to do this or anything, and remember, this is a developer's beta. I'm going to show you how to install. So this basically means there are lots of bugs out there still. There's lots of things that need to be sorted out with macOS Ventura, and this is what a developer's beta is all about. It's about discovering bugs and also fixing things. So it's at your own risk to do this. The second thing I'd like to point out is make sure you do a backup of your current Mac right away. So make sure you do something like a Time Machine backup. I'm not responsible for the loss of any apps or any kind of data. So please make sure you do a backup just in case you want to go back to, say, macOS Monterey, for example. So with that out of the way, let's go over now to the MacBook on the table and let me show you how to install macOS Ventura onto your own Mac. So here's my MacBook Air, and what I wanted to show you quickly here, just to show you which MacBook Air that I have here, this is the M1 MacBook Air with 8 GB of RAM inside it. So it's ready to go. I'm just going to do a quick software update just to show you guys. This is on the latest version of macOS Monterey at this time, what is version 12.4. So that is the latest version right now when I'm creating this video. So make sure you've done that. Make sure you've done the software update. So let's close this down. Next one to do is open up Safari, and it has to be Safari. And what you want to type into the search is this. You want to type in beta profile. Just type that in, beta profile, and then just press enter. And then what you want to do is click on this first link here on betaprofile.com. Now you may get a few ads, just close them down, don't worry about them, but scroll right down, and there we go. We should see macOS beta profile for macOS 13. So what you want to do is click on install profile. Oh, another ad, let's just get rid of that. And there we go, you should get this message. You want to click allow, and it will download the beta profile on that. So with this, what we can just do, we can actually close down Safari. We don't need it anymore. So it's in here in my little stack here where I've downloaded it, and you can open it up from here. But just to show people don't have a stack, go to your Finder, go to your downloads, and there we go. Here we go, here's my macOS developer beta. So I'm just gonna open that up, and we just want to run this, click continue, continue again for the terms, conditions, and agree to them. Again, click install. You might need to just put your touch ID or your password in, whatever you want to do on that one. Oh, and then everything's kicking off already. You might get this message saying update not found, but don't worry about that. Just click OK. It will do another search for updates. And as you can see, there we go. macOS 13 beta ready to go. I'm just going to close down these bits and pieces in the background because we don't need them now. So we can close down everything else like the installer, downloads, and yeah, there we go. We can move this to the bin, we don't need it because we've got the beta profile installed. But there we go, we've got the macOS 13 beta. I'm just going to delete my bin. And what we want to do after this then is just click upgrade now. So click on this, we'll just accept the terms conditions. We want to put in our passcode. So my passcode is just a simple one on this Mac, which is 1234. It's not my passcode I use, I've just done it for a demo. And then what will start to happen is the actual downloading of macOS of Ventura will start, and you can just leave this be. Now, depending on how fast your broadband speed is and your connection speed, it depends on how long this will take to download. So you can see here it's quite a few gigs to download, so it's taking some good time here. I've got a 1 gigabit connection, so it's quite quick for my one, but it might take a bit longer, it might be quicker on your machine. So we just want to leave this ready to go, and then after that, what's going to happen, it's going to prepare to install everything. So basically this is just getting the kind of unpacking of the file you've just downloaded and getting everything ready to install. Again, this may take some time to do the preparing, depending on how fast or how quick your computer is, or how old or how new it is. It might take a few minutes, it might take about half an hour to an hour to fully complete doing the full preparing. Just be patient on this and just let it run. So once this is fully completed, like it is now, You can see in the top corner that basically I've got a notification saying my computer's going to start in around about 50 seconds or so. So what we want to do is just let this complete, or you can just click the upgrade now. I'm just going to let this run. I'm going to fast forward this. So basically we just need to let macOS Ventura install now, and we don't need to touch the MacBook at all. So just quickly, guys, while macOS Ventura is installing onto your Mac, I want to talk about the giveaway that I'm doing right now on this channel. And it is for this. This is for a MacBook Air. And by the way, this is a different MacBook Air to the one that's in the video right now, just in case you were wondering there. But this MacBook Air, I am doing an international giveaway of it. And it's a 512GB model. And it comes with 8GB of RAM. And I'm going to be giving this away to one lucky subscriber when we get over 400,000 subscribers. And to be honest, it's not that far away. And all you need to do to get your hands possibly on this is write down in the comments below of what Apple gear, what technology gear you're planning to buy in 2022. And if you are new here, make sure you subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell, because I'll be creating a video announcing who the winner is, and you don't want to miss out on that. Now, something else I just want to quickly mention, there are a lot of scammers, there are a lot of spammers out there as well. Some of them even impersonating myself, what isn't really cool, to be honest. And they're saying that you've won a prize, and to Telegram them or to WhatsApp them. Ignore these people completely or report them, because they are not me. You've heard it from me, myself. I'll be announcing who the winner is once we get over 400,000 subscribers, and only then via a video. With that out of the way, let's go back to the MacBook Air and let's see how it's doing with the installation of macOS. So once you come back to the main screen, you just want to put your passcode in. And funny enough, this is what's a bit different with macOS Ventura if you've installed previous versions. You'll actually get the kind of countdown, as you can see here, beginning with your actual sort of background in the background, as it were. You don't actually have sort of black and white page with the kind of countdown with the bar. So this is a bit different this time. Again, just leave this run and basically macOS Ventura will install. So with it fully installed, all we want to do now is we just want to put a touch ID, so we put our code in. We just want to accept the analytics here, just the usual procedures. Screen time, I'm gonna set it up later, I'm not really gonna do that. I'm also, because it's a test machine, I'm not gonna turn on iCloud, but I'm gonna do the auto here. And as you can see, it's in the evening where I am now. So there we go. We've got the feedback assistant, close that down. I'm gonna close down Safari here just quickly. But there we have it, macOS Ventura install. I'm just going to show you here about this Mac. Sorry, my camera's trying to focus on the background here, but you can see MacBook Air here, Apple M1, and as you can see here, Ventura version 13. And you can even tell this is a different kind of page, how it used to look. Look at this, you've got everything on the left-hand side. But you can see here we've got macOS version 13 beta at the bottom. And yeah, all the lists and everything. It's all a different kind of view here for your system settings and system preferences. So I'm going to get a bit more used to that. But just again, just to double show you, or just to show you guys again, I'm just going to go to software update. I'm just going to quickly just do an update, see if there isn't any. There probably isn't, because like I said, this is the first beta. But there we go, we're fully up to date and we're running the latest version. So next of all, guys, let's just close this down and let me show you some of the features. So one of the big features has got to be Stage Manager. So let's just open that up here. You can see it's a Stage Manager here. Let's click that open. So let's get, say, Safari open. It is definitely switched on. Yeah, there we go. It's flicked to the side there. So if I get Maps open, and there we go. I've got Safari on the side. I've got my Maps and everything like that set up, so that's all nicely work. I can flick between them. Let's get calendar open. Again, it's not been set up, but you can see it's appeared. Let's do podcast, why not? But you can see I've got all the different things, news, they're all stacking up here on the side, and I can just flick easily between them. So it's really, really cool, this new Stage Manager ability. And remember, this is on iPad OS 16 as well, and I have made a guide for this. But let's turn off Stage Manager on this, and let's just close this down if I can. News is going mental. Can't close down news. What's going on? Let's close down the Maps. I can't actually close this down. I'm trying to close it. There we go. And let's see if I can close down news now. I still can't turn it off. It's asking me a pop-up. There we go. That's better. Now I can close down news, and I've got my Maps and everything. I'm going to close that all down. So everything is fully working on this machine, and it is really, really cool. So as you can see, guys, it was really easy to install macOS Ventura onto your machine. And like I said, there's some great new features on here, like Stage Manager, also the ability to like use your iPhone as a webcam. So yeah, do have a good play around because it is really, really cool. The other thing also I just want to mention, guys, that if you do want to go back, make sure to use your Time Machine backup to restore back to Monterey or to Big Sur, whatever kind of operating system you were on before. And with that, guys, it's also time to wrap up this video. So if you have enjoyed watching it, please do press the like button. And also at the same time, if you want to hear the latest Apple news, reviews, and comparisons, please make sure you subscribe to this channel and also hit that notification bell. Until next time, guys, I will see you really soon. Bye-bye.